Yeah, very good morning to you all. Today we are going to
good morning sir.
Today we are going to see the topic. The name of the topic is stellar spectra. Stellar is the another name to define the star. To see the spectral lines, the spectral lines which emitted from the star. We are discussing unit number 3. In unit number 3, for today's topic, stellar spectra, we are going to see the spectrum colors. As we know, in general, WBGR colors, violet to red, the formation of the rainbow. So that we are going to see from this unit, from this topic. So here, we are going to consider two scientific assumptions. One is Wien's theory, and another one is the Balmer's theory. So we are going to consider these two theories. With respect to these two theories, we are going to study the stellar spectra. Objective. A star plays a vital role in understanding the secrets of the universe. So as we know that the universe is made up of celestial bodies. The formation of the celestial bodies is nothing but it's in the form of a star. So the star plays a vital role in the understanding the secrets of the galaxy, universe. By studying the nature of the star, we can learn about the formation of the planets. We learn the origin of the elements. We see the characteristics of the Milky Way galaxy and study the future of our solar system. So from these big stellar star or stellar spectra, we are going to study the distribution of energy. So energy is distributed. How this energy is distributed? According to the authors Wien and Balmer, they are studying the distribution of the energy in terms of colors. The distribution of energy is in the form of colors. In the form of colors. So here this distribution of the energy is studied with respect to the frequency or wavelength and the temperature. So based on the wavelength or a frequency and the temperature, induced temperature, because we know the layers at the center core of the sun is very, very huge. That is a hot matter is there. So the temperature will be high. So surrounding the core, we can say that the temperature will reduces slowly. So the distribution of the energy, the radiation which emitted from the core of the sun's core, will depends on the temperature and also the wavelength. So from this lecture, we are going to study the distribution of energy, in the form of colors. It's based on the wavelength and the temperature. So this is our objective. Studying the distribution of energy in the form of a color with respect to wavelength and temperature. Let's start with the introduction. So introduction here, we know that a star is a very large ball. Actually, we can say that it's a huge body. A star is a huge body of bright glowing hot matter. We say that a bright glowing hot matter in space. So this bright glowing hot matter is nothing but it has a tremendous amount of heat and light. So the tremendous amount of heat and light, it's called as a bright glowing hot matter in space. So this bright glowing hot matter is called as plasma. A plasma is the ionized radiation, as we know in general. Plasma is the ionized radiation. So this ionized radiation here, it happens due to the fusion, due to the collision, due to the gravitational disturbance. The two particles, one is the gaseous cloud, that is gaseous molecules, and another one is the surrounding particles, ionized particles. When these are two medium, gaseous cloud and the particle collides with the each other, due to the gravitational distribution or a disturbance, a hot matter takes place at the center of the star or a sun. So we are just saying that a star is a very large ball. Star is a very large ball of a bright glowing hot matter in space. So this bright glowing hot matter in space, it's called as a plasma. So actually this plasma, it's held together by its own gravity. So due to this, we are able to see at the center, it's very hot. At the center, it's very hot, which in turns, a nuclear fusion reaction, creates a nuclear fusion reaction. So as we know, the nuclear fusion reaction is nothing collision between the two elements. So this collision in the nuclear fusion reaction makes the center of to be bigger and bigger. The size will be increased. So the increase in size is with respect to the chemical elements. So this will be the formation of the star. This it's called the formation of the star. Here, for our today's topic, stellar spectra, spectrum of colors. Star is classified on the basis of color and luminosity. The star is classified on the basis of the colors and luminosity. Luminosity is measured in terms of magnitude. We are going to consider two principles. One is the color and another is the luminosity. So the color is measured in terms of a temperature and the luminosity is measured in terms of a magnitude. So as I already said that we are going to consider Wien's and the Balmer theories. So from the Wien's theory, we are going to study the temperature variation. And from the Balmer theory, we are going to study the hydrogen lines variation. hydrogen lines variation. So these are two theory which we have considered here. A star is classified on the basis of color. So it's from the Wien's theory, and luminosity, it's from the Balmer's theory. So the color in terms of a temperature, luminosity is studied in terms of a magnitude. Then, according to the scientist Edward Pickering's, William Fleming's, and Etienne Levet, so they just categorized the various types of stars. They categorized the various types of stars in accordance with the obtained spectrum. So we are going to study the classification of the stars also in future. So this classification, it's based on the scientific assumptions of Edward Fleming's and Hetita. Then according to the scientist Hertzsprung's and Henry Ronis Russell's, so they just formulated a basic law actually. So they formulated a basic law. By that, we can study the various spectrum and its nature. So here, we are going to study this formulation of the star in the form of a graph. So that's why we are just naming as HR diagram, HR graph. So from this HR diagram, HR graph, we are going to study the information about the temperature, information about the chemical composition present in the medium, and the intrinsic luminosity. The intrinsic luminosity is nothing but the center core. So the sun classified into two layers, internal layer as well as the external layer. So the external layer are the temperature variation, chemical composition. The internal layer is the intrinsic luminosity. The total structure of the sun or a star we are going to be study. But here we are given the variation, categorized the medium into three parts. One as the temperature variation, second as a chemical composition variation, and the third as intrinsic luminosity variation. So this is the introduction. We are going to classify the star into two types based on the colors and the luminosity. Color is measured in terms of a temperature, and a luminosity is measured in terms of a magnitude. The concept of the stellar spectra was defined by a scientist Edward Fleming's and Henrietta. So they formulated and they categorized the star into many groups. Then according to the authors Hertzsprung's and Russell, they formulated a graph. They created a graph in which they explained the information about the temperature, chemical composition, and the intrinsic luminosity of the star. So this is the our main topic for today's class. We are going to study the three basic important properties of the star. So these are three basic important properties of the star will characterize the total nature of the celestial body star. The three basic properties are, first one is a spectrum. As we know, a spectrum is the colors. Second one is the apparent brightness. So here we are having two types of the brightness, but we are considering the apparent brightness. So this apparent brightness is nothing but a flux, the radiation which emits from the medium. So these flux is nothing but, we have already heard about this word flux, but in a different manner, in the solar wind. So the solar wind is nothing but a flux. And the third one is the parallax. So these parallax, which gives rise to measure the distance. So we are going to measure the distance between the two medium, two objects. So the distance between these two objects is measured with the method of parallax. So generally we are going to consider three important properties here. First one is the spectrum, second one is the apparent brightness, and the third one is the parallax. See, a star spectrum is our first consideration to measure the composition and its surface temperature. So from the first property, we are going to measure the compositions and the structure or surface temperature. The second property is the apparent brightness. So here in this apparent brightness, we are going to measure the absolute magnitude. And in the third case, we are going to measure the radius of the star, or we are going to measure the total mass of the star from this parallax method. So we have taken a three parameters: spectra, brightness, parallax. Spectra, surface temperature, brightness, magnitude, parallax, mass of the star. So let's see the first parameter, spectrum. Spectrum, it defined as the amount of energy that the star puts out at every wavelength. Actually, we know what is the spectrum. So the spectrum is the color. The spectrum is the output which emits from the medium. So in the last class, we have considered the structure. So here we are having a source, a monochromatic source. So when this monochromatic light source falls on the grating, once it strikes the grating, as a result, we can able to see a n number of colors. So these n number of colors is nothing but the diffracted spectrum. See, the amount of energy that the star puts out at every wavelength. The amount of energy is just emitted by the medium with various frequency. We can able to see the different colors here, violet to the red. So the each color or each spectra will have its own characteristics. It is based on the presence of the wavelength or its frequency. So these only we are going to be study here in detail. As we already informed and we also known that in the previous class, we have taken the comparison. Here we have shown the comparison between the normal spectra and the stellar spectra. So in the normal spectra, there is no gas medium. We have only an air medium. But in the stellar spectra, we know that the formation of the nebula or the formation of the celestial bodies or the object in the universe is only with respect to the dust and the gaseous molecules. So when the source falls on the gaseous substance, so these gaseous molecule consisting of n number of gaseous particles, as we all know that the medium seems to be in a cloud, so it be called as a molecular cloud. So these molecular cloud consisting of an elements, when the element absorbs radiation, as a result, we can able to see that there are some emission of the spectra. That emission of the spectra here shown in the dark line. You can able to see this, a dark line, a spacing between the spectrum. So this is a spacing between the spectrum. Here it's called as an absorption spectrum. Actually, it's shown as an absorption spectrum. So this absorption is takes place by the gaseous particles. The gaseous particles gained the energy, acquired the energy. So they acquired the energy and they transmitted that energy in a different manner that we can able to see here in the emission spectra. So when the is nothing but the radiation. When the radiation falls on the, so here in the molecular cloud, we know that a medium consisting of an particles. So these molecular particle, when it interacts with this electromagnetic radiation, as a result, we can able to see the absorption spectra as well as the emission spectra. What is this absorption spectra and the emission spectra? We are having just a dark line. So this dark line is nothing but the color or the wavelength or the energy is absorbed by the gaseous particle. That absorbed energy we have shown here as the emission spectra. So the blank space here, it's mentioned here. And similarly, the second medium, here it's in a dark line. So this dark line is nothing but it's shown in the emission spectra. And also this dark line here, it's shown in the emission spectra. So as the result, we are able to get, there are two types of the spectrums will be occurred when the electromagnetic radiation, it collides with the stellar cloud. One is the absorption spectra and another one is the emission spectra. See, these dark lines, it's nothing but it's called as an Fraunhofer lines. So we are not discussing about an optical theory. If we are studying about the optical phenomena, that time we have to study the lines also, Fraunhofer lines and Fraenkel's lines, Fresnel's lines. So we are not discussing about the lines, but we have to know that these lines is nothing but an Fraunhofer lines. See, if we know the position of these lines, if we know the position of the lines, so here it's located near to the origin. It's little farther to the origin. It is at the middle of the origin, and likewise, we can just distinguish the absorption lines as well as we can show the emission lines. So based on the position of the spectra, we can study the characteristics of the medium. So these only we have to study. Based on the position of the spectra, we can study the characteristics of the medium. So this is our consideration. So from this class, we are going to study only these things. See, the amount of energy that the star puts out at every wavelength, it's called as spectra. Basically, there are three kinds of spectra. One is continuous spectra, emission spectra, and absorption spectra. Our case is the stellar spectra. So these are the absorption spectra. So we are discussing about the star characterization. So the star characterized in the form of an absorption spectra. So it's looked like a rainbow. Actually, we know that the rainbow, formation of the rainbow. So the so they look like a continuous rainbow of a colors interrupted by dark. Against the, is not this point, the absorbed wavelength appeared as in the dark lines. That only we have shown here. Here we can see that the absorbed spectra. So this absorbed spectra is nothing but an absorbed line. So the line is nothing but an energy. The energy is completely captured by the ionized particles. Energy is completely captured by the ionized particle. That's why we are saying that here we are having the dark lines. Dark line is nothing but an empty space. An empty region is created between these colors. So these empty space we have shown here in the emission spectra. So the first spectra is the continuous spectra. There is no just absorption and there is no emission. It's completely diffracted. The second spectra is the absorption spectra. So some of the gaseous molecules gained the electromagnetic radiation and the energy is captured by the medium. And the third spectrum shows both the absorption as well as the emission. Here the dark line is nothing but an empty space, absorbed energy space. So here that absorbed energy space is present. Now, as I already informed that, we are going to consider two scientific assumptions. One is Wien's law and another one is the hydrogen line. That is a Balmer lines of hydrogen. So we are going to consider two scientific assumptions, one from the Wien's and another from the Balmer's. So what we are going to show, what we are going to study from these two assumptions. So from the Wien's law, we are going to study the temperature variation. Temperature variation. See, here we have considered a plot. From this graph, along the x direction, we have taken the wavelength. Along the y direction, we have taken the spectral irradiation. A spectral irradiation is nothing but an exploration. The emission of the colors. So the emitted rays, it's along the y direction. The wavelength, it's along the x direction. So here we are going to study this concept with respect to the temperature. With respect to the temperature. We can able to see the colors here. So our consideration is a blue color. Our consideration is a green color. And our consideration is a red color. So even though we can able to see n number of colors here, but we are going to consider only the three colors. That's why we have mentioned highlighted here in the Balmer's assumption. The blue color, so here it's be the first region. Green color, so here it's be the second region. And the red color, here it's be the third region. So we are going to explain these stellar spectra with respect to these three colors, according to the authors, Wien's and the Balmer. So let's see one by one. So here, according to the authors of Wien's, he considered a plot. So from this plot, we are just going to consider the temperature variation. So from the Balmer's assumption, here we have mentioned the symbol. So these symbols is nothing but the types of the stars. Star O type, B type, A type, F type, G type, K type, and M type. So already I have seen that the classification of the star. So the star are classified into two ways. One from the HR assumption and another one is from the Hardware's assumption. So the Balmer hydrogen lines is explained with respect to the Hardware's assumption. Hardware's assumption. So from these Hardware's assumption, we have just classified the stars into many groups. The first type is the O type, second type is a B type, third type is A type, similarly F type, G type, K type, and M type. So let's see these in detail. The first consideration which I have taken here is the Wien's displacement, that is a Wien's law. So the Wien's law deals with the temperature variation. This we have to be know. The Wien's means it will deal with the temperature variation. Balmer means it deals with the just levels. Balmer means it deals with the levels. The each line is nothing but a level. As we know that from the energy level diagram. So basically the energy level diagram consisting of three layer. One is a ground state and the second one is the forbidden energy state and the third one is the higher state. So here the hydrogen lines from the Balmer's assumption observed from the Hartwig's theory explains the energy lines, explains the energy lines, so that we study in detail. So let here we are discussing the Wien's. The Wien's means a temperature variation. So according to Wien's law, lambda temperature. So lambda temperature is equal to 30000000. So nearly 30 lakhs. So this is a formula, empirical formula, which was formulated already by the scientist Wien's. So according to this formula, we can say that the wavelength, wavelength means the color. The wavelength is inversely proportional to the temperature. See, a wavelength is inversely proportional to the temperature. If you bring this temperature, if you bring this T value here, it comes here. So the wavelength is inversely proportional to the temperature. So the temperature here, it's not a constant. Temperature here, it's not a constant. The temperature variation is happens here. With respect to this temperature variation only, we are allocating, we are classifying the colors into many. That's why we have seen that according to Wien's, the wavelength is inversely proportional to the temperature. Here the wavelength is measured in terms of an Armstrong unit, and the temperature is measured in terms of a degree Kelvin. The Wien's law is used to determine the temperature of the star. So we are going to determine the temperature of the star. So the temperature of the star is determined, is studied with respect to the hotter object to the colder object, from the origin, that is from the core to the surface. So what the variation, that only we are going to be study. That is mentioned here as hotter object to the cooler object, colder object or a cooler object. So here let's see the variation one by one. So we have shown that Wien's means a wavelength is inversely proportional to the temperature. So these are Wien's law used to determine the temperature of the star. We are going to determine the temperature of the star. So that only I have mentioned here. Temperature of the star, the wavelength. The wavelength means these colors. So these are the wavelength region. See, we can able to see that there is no and a continuous just a spectrum. There is no and a continuous spectrum. So there we can see up to one level, one color, violet. So above this region, it's a blue. Above the region, it's a green, then bluish green, then yellow, then it seems to be on a slight orange, then completely the red. So there is an just a maximum displacement and also and a minimum displacement. So we just to show that the wavelength is inversely proportional to the temperature. See, from the Wien's theory, we are measuring the temperature actually. It's used to determine the temperature of the star. So from this graph, we can easily understood. We can easily observe that what the change is going to be happens. So what Wien's has explained from this graph. So I have considered three regions here. One is a hotter region. Second one is the vertex region, that is a medium region, moderate region, middle region. And the third one is the coolest region. See, for the hottest region, the temperature is about 7000 Kelvin. For the vertex region, the temperature is about at 6000 Kelvin. And for the coolest region, the temperature is at 5000 Kelvin. So from these, we can just show that, we can say that, so based on the temperature, based on the temperature variation, we are getting the various spectral colors. When the temperature is large, because it's a core, the region here, it's in a core. So near to the core, we know the core is nothing but a plasma, hot glowing matter. So there the temperature will be very, very large. When the temperature is seems to be in a very large, at that region, we can able to say that the star looks like a blue in color. The star looks like a blue in color. When it's at the moderate, the star looks like a green color. When it's near to the just a surface atmosphere of the sun, the star looks like a reddish in color. So we are able to see these reddish in color during the solar eclipse. So during the solar eclipse time, we can able to see these variations. So the hotter region of the star is at 7000 Kelvin. The vertex region of the star is nearly at 6000 Kelvin. And the coolest region of the star is at nearly 5000 Kelvin. So what we are just seeing here, that only we are going to be seeing in the next slide as in the elaborated way. See, UV region, the region, we have classified the region here. The first range is in a UV. We can't able to see through our naked eyes. The second region, it's in a visible. So we can able to see this through our naked eyes. The third region is in a infrared. So these also we cannot able to see through our naked eyes. So we are having three regions. One, it's an visible one, and another two, it's an invisible one. So these invisible regions we are now studying with the help of some satellites and with the help of some telescopes. See, what we have considered here, the same principle, the same mechanism I have shown here also. The first is the hottest region. We can say that the first is in the hottest region. The second is in a moderate region. And the third is in a just a coolest region or cooler region. The hottest region, the temperature is around 7000 Kelvin. The wavelength actually, the wavelength here, it's mentioned in terms of an Armstrong unit. But here we have taken this in terms of a nanometer. So I have mentioned both. So the temperature for a star with a maximum wavelength at 4000 Armstrongs, that is at a 400 nanometer, is about 7000 Kelvin. So under this region, we can able to say or see that the star emits more energy per unit area than the cooler stars, than the remaining areas. So these be the very, very hottest region when compared to the other regions. So this region is be a very, very hottest region compared to this cooler region. We are discussing only about the just visible spectrums. We are not discussing about UV, and also we are not discussing about infrared. So from the infrared, we can just narrate more microwave and so on, we can say that, but we are not discussing about that. We are studying only the visual spectra. So one is the hottest region, it's in the form of a blue color. The second variation is the vertex variation. The temperature for the star with a maximum wavelength at about 5000 Armstrong, that is of 500 nanometer. So these just a maximum emission is a takes place for 6000 Kelvin. So this maximum emission takes place for 6000 Kelvin at the frequency range or at the wavelength range of 500 nanometer. The last classification is the coolest star, the coolest region of the star. So here for this coolest region, the temperature induced is 5000 Kelvin. For this 5000 Kelvin, we can able to see the maximum emission of the radiation is take place around 600 nanometer. So this line is the maximum emission. So this is a maximum emission. Above there will be no any increase radiation, but then it will starts to fall down. That decreasing is nothing but the second stage of the beginning. So this is the maximum, then it goes to the second stage. So this is the maximum, then it goes to the third stage. So the stages are developed when the temperature, it tends to reduces. We are decreasing the temperature as per the assumption. The temperature is decreased from the higher point to the lower point. When it's higher, we can able to see the star. It seems to be in a hotter one. It's in the form of a blue color. When the temperature is slightly reduces, then the star, it seems to be in the green color. When the temperature is reduced furthermore, then we can able to see the star is in the red color. So these are three classifications we are studied from the Wien's theory. So we can conclude that the star that emits mostly bright lights to emit more energy. That is a blue lights to emit more energy. The initial emission is nothing but a blue color. And it's modified further. And finally, we are able to see that it's in the form of a red color. So the star that emits mostly blue light to emit more energy than a star that emits mostly red light, that is in the cooler region. So blue to the red, it's the formation of the star. This slide, actually the Balmer's theory, according to the his assumption, it's defined as the change in the strength of the hydrogen line. The change in the strength of the hydrogen line with respect to the temperature. With respect to the temperature. It is often called as Balmer thermometer. Balmer thermometer. So the strength of the hydrogen line is distinguished with respect to the temperature absorption. So already I have said that energy level diagram is the basic principle to explain, to understand this Balmer theory. If you know what is energy level diagram, then this concept will be very, very easy for you all. So the Balmer theory studied with respect to the lines. Here the lines are called as hydrogen lines because the surface atmosphere of the sun, it contains more hydrogen elements. So according to the author, he has taken that hydrogen line for this absorption as well as for this emission spectra. So we can see we are having both the variation, absorption and also the emission. So from this Balmer's theory, when the star positioning the O, when the star positioning the O, actually the O is nothing but the initial. So here we can see that the star seems to be a hotter one, seems to be a hotter one. The color, it's in the form of a blue. The color, it's in the form of a blue. So how this modification takes place? How this variation takes place? So the variation takes place only with respect to the level. The variation takes place only with respect to the presence of the level. So in each level, according to the author's assumption, he has taken an electron actually. So each level consisting of an electron. See, this level is nothing but a gate. We can consider this level as a gate. So this will be the first gate, this will be the second gate, this will be the third gate, this will be the fourth gate, and this will be the fifth gate, and the last gate. So each gate consisting of an electron. So what happened? When we subject the temperature variation, when we subject the energy to this medium, the electrons which was presented in this medium gain that energy. After gathering the energy, the electron will goes to some other point. That's the emission of the radiation. So when the electrons in this region will goes to this initial region to some other region, a gap will be created. Then the electrons which was below this region, they will acquire the energy and they will starts to exit. So like way, the excitations of the energy will be takes place in the medium. So this is the Balmer's assumption. The radiation from the center of the sun, the radiation from the center of the sun core, it transmitted to the surface of the material. So we know the sun, we know the star. So it's in a spheroid. So at the center only, it's very, very hot. But on the surface, it's not on a hotter medium. So what happens? The energy is transmitted. The energy is transmitted from the center to the surface. So the observation is made by the Balmer. So it's a very good way to determine the temperature of the star. So the easiest way to determine the temperature of the star is the Balmer's hydrogen lines. So from this hydrogen lines, from this position, we can easily determine the temperature of the star. So that's all for today's topic. See, we can here just shown the comparison. We can able to see the comparison according to the Hartwig's theory. So from the Hartwig's theory only, we are just positioning the stars. We are classifying the star O type, B type, A type, F type, G type, K type, M type. O type means brightest. O type means the brightest. B type is the blue white and bright. A star are less bright. F are brighter than our sun, solar system. And G is our sun. And K, it's a dimmer. And M is the dimmest. So here we have shown the classifications, the changes, the stages with respect to the temperature. So the classification is named by the scientist Hartwig's. So that's why it's called as a Hartwig's classification or Hartwig's system. The star, stellar has classified here into O, B, M, F, G, K, M. So these are types. So with this, just we conclude our today's topic. If you have any doubt regarding this, you can raise your question. We can clarify it. If you have any doubt, you can ask.
No, sir.
Is it clear? Is it audible? Can you hear me?